So I just got out of a meeting not that long ago, and it was a team meeting with the Gertz team, and we're hanging out with all the agents, and we're going through different contracts. And one of the things that came up was EMD, and how it's a term that as real estate agents we use a lot, and we kind of throw it around there. But what we find is that a lot of buyers and general population, people don't know what this term means and understand it. So this video, this vlog, is gonna cover that in more detail so you can be more prepared when you're going into buying a home or selling a home, especially if you're a first-time buyer. Hey, what's up everybody? It's Brant Green, your mail-in realtor with the Gertz team of Long & Foster. And today we're gonna go through in depth what an EMD is. So an EMD is just an earnest money deposit. An earnest money deposit is a good faith deposit. It's basically the money that you put down as a deposit, showing your intention, your sincere intention to buy someone's home. And what it does is it really just kind of buys you time between the date of putting in the offer and the date of closing. And it buys you time to get things done like inspections and appraisals. Typically, what you can expect is a 1 to 2% of the sales price of the home as an earnest money deposit. Sometimes it can be as high as 10% depending on how competitive the market is. So if you have a home that there's a lot of interest in, or you're trying to get a jump on it, or you really just want to secure the home, you may want to pay a higher earnest money deposit to show your intentions or even more sincere to buy that home. In some cases, it can be just a flat fee. It might be $5,000 or $10,000. It just depends on the situation. When you go into a contract with a buyer and a seller, their earnest money deposit is going to have some contingencies. And so what this means is we're putting a down payment on a home, but if the buyer messes up or the seller messes up along the way, that money, that earnest money deposit that's in escrow could be retained by the buyer or the seller, depending on the situation. This is why it's so important to make sure that you're working with a real estate agent that understands contracts and they're going through in detail with you all the things that matter in that contract, the things that you need to know. An example could be a home appraisal. So if you're a buyer and you put down an earnest money deposit on a home showing sincere intention to buy that home, but it's contingent upon the home appraising for the value that it's stated at or that it's selling for. So that gives you time to get the home appraised. If that appraisal comes back and it meets the terms of the contract, then now you're locked into that contract because it met the contingency. But if that home appraisal came in maybe under the value of the home that's being sold for, you have the right as the buyer to get that earnest money deposit back and move on. On the other side of things, if you're a buyer and you put an earnest money deposit down on a home that you intend to buy, and the contingency is that the buyer has to get financing secured within 30 days, and the buyer doesn't meet that timeline, the seller has a reserved right to keep that deposit and the buyer doesn't get it back. The point is that you want to protect yourself and your earnest money deposit. So make sure you read the contract. Make sure your agent reads the contract and understands exactly what's going on, what contingencies are in there, what stipulations are in there, and make sure that you're doing your job, whether you're on the buyer end or the seller's end, to make sure everything's done correct. So this means making sure that the contingencies for the inspection and the financing are in place. You make sure that you read and abide by the terms of the contract. Know what those are. And make sure that the funds are handled appropriately. Make sure you're working with a reputable third-party brokerage or title company or escrow, and make sure that your money is secure and safe. Hopefully that helps you now understand what EMD means. And so if you go into a transaction where you're gonna look to buy or sell a home, you have a little bit more clarity on what that earnest money deposit means and what you need to be paying attention to. So that's it for today's vlog, and hopefully you guys enjoyed it. If you have questions, put it down in the comments below, like and subscribe to the video, and feel free to reach out at any point if you have any questions. If you know anybody that's looking to buy or sell a home, please reach out and I'd love to work with you. With that, I'll see you guys next time. Take care.